aren't enemy number one on my hit list or anything, but I can't profess to love a fly. They're annoying, they're creepy, they're dirty, they spread disease. So would it be so bad if they went extinct? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that looks to answer a multitude of queries. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate, and today I'm asking, what if flies went extinct? Let me know your thoughts in the comments section down below and answer me this. Can you sleep in a room with a fly in? Because I absolutely cannot. They're foul beasts. I get horrible, horrible paranoia that they're gonna land on my face and I won't even know because I'm asleep and it's an utter nightmare. Blah! Also, renditions of There Was an Old Lady Who Swallowed a Fly are quite welcome and very necessary, so go hell for leather in the comments section.
Why don't you make a point with your own doctor?
You know...
What's wrong?
I think I swallowed a fly!
No.
I swallowed a fly! What do I do? What can happen?
Also, while you're down there, why don't you like this video and share it with a friend that needs a question answered today? Why don't you click on that big beautiful notification bell to stay up to date with our big answers? Stick around to the end of the video as I'm going to be replying to some comments. Okay, flies. Flies, flies, flies. Does anyone know how many flies there are in the world? It's more than you think. Let me tell you. One source tells me that there are 17 quadrillion flies in existence, and another tells me that there are 17 million for every person on Earth. Now, I'm not sure that the mathematics quite add up here, but either way, there are a lot of flies. There are 160,000 known species of flies, and entomologists, people who study insects, so know way more about this topic than you and I, they can only speculate how many species we don't know about. It could be thousands, it could be millions. The sheer volume of flies in question make this question difficult to answer in under 10 minutes, as we're literally talking quadrillions of insects, so we'll try and keep this one as basic as possible. As always though, our source links are in the description box and I would always encourage reading around the topic if it interests you. Flies are not irredeemable baddies like mosquitoes, they actually are forces of both good and bad. On the plus side, flies help pollinate plants and crop and kind of grow. Grotesquely, they also eat sludge in our drain pipes, eat deadwood, human and animal excrement, and their larvae eat dead bodies, which, again, actually, is a good thing. On the bad side, flies are damaging to crop, they spread disease and sickness, and in general, they're just pests. Again, note the fear of one landing on my face while I'm asleep. So let's start with what would get better if we had no flies, namely, way less sleepless nights with a fly trapped in your bedroom. But actually, major economies would be billions of dollars better off. Flies are part of the pest threat, causing $120 billion of damage to the United States agriculture industry alone. They also threaten the agricultural efforts of Europe, Canada, Australia, South America, Asia, and more. Various species of flies cause damage to crop or plants themselves. Others damage the produce by laying eggs inside fruit or vegetables, which makes them rot and unfit for human consumption. Flies also harm agriculture by bothering cattle, which causes a deterioration in their health, and certain flies, including blowflies, can infest sheep wool, which also can severely damage economies. We discussed this in our malaria video, but there is a definite crossover here. Flies can be vectors for pathogens which spread disease. As well as malaria and friends from mosquitoes, leishmaniasis is caused by the sandfly. Tsetse flies can cause what is known in Africa as sleeping sickness, and deer flies can cause a plethora of issues too. Common houseflies can spread intestinal infections such as dysentery, cholera, and typhoid, which are treatable but have been known to kill. Bad news. On the upside though, flies eat nasty things, which sounds like a bad thing, and to be honest, they can also spread their nasties to human food sources and make us sick. But aside from that, flies are great at helping us get rid of drain sludge, like we said, human excrement, and decomposing bodies. Blue bottle flies and blowflies, for example, are helpful in cleaning up the earth as they lay their eggs into dead animal carcasses. These eggs hatch to larvae or maggots, which eat away part of the waste, and if they didn't, well, there'd be a lot more nasty, smelling, decaying bodies out there just hanging around. To add some stats to the matter, it seems that researchers in Costa Rica have fed organic household waste to larvae of the black soldier fly and found that maggots reduce the waste by up to 75%. Recycling is cool, so maybe so are flies. While flies do damage crops, they're also helpful in pollinating plants. Midges, for example, help pollinate the cacao plant, which is where we get chocolate. No flies, no chocolate, or very expensive chocolate as demand outweighs supply. fly. Hoverflies are also fundamental in generating eucalyptus and tea tree. The list goes on. One of the main issues we would face, other than the lack of chocolate of course, would be the knock-on effect of the lack of flies had on the rest of the ecosystem. How many flies did we say there were? Something like 17 quadrillion? At this point, that's an unfathomable number to our minds. It's a seemingly make-believe string of words, but in reality, this would mean a lot of hungry animals. Spiders, birds, and frogs are among the animals which eat flies. In industrial farming, the black soldier fly has been used to feed chickens, fish, and pigs. This could be a more sustainable way of keeping livestock. Some are even suggesting that humans start eating certain flies in order to feed our hungry and constantly growing population. Flies have been around for millions of years. Literally, millions. Flies have been doing their thing for much longer than humans. If they disappear, there would be good outcomes, but for the most part, it would be bad, as a major link in the food chain would be missing. Ultimately though, their extinction is very unlikely. There are a lot of them and they breed very quickly. Common houseflies can lay up to 150 eggs in one sitting and around 500 in their lifespans of a few short weeks. Flies are a staple part of our present, and they may even be an exciting part of our developing future. Aside from possibly being used as a food source for the swelling population, it's also suggested that they could assist with our need for sustainable fuel. Researchers have been able to extract oil from the black soldier fly larvae that can be used as a biodiesel. Honestly, I've certainly heard it all now. So guys, flies. What are your thoughts? What did you learn from this? Are you able to sleep in a room with a fly loose goose and ready to land on your face? All of the important questions. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. Before I go, I'm going to read some comments from one of my most recent videos, What If Mosquitoes Went Extinct? This is what you had to say. Our most liked comment was ironically from the most hated idiot on the internet. They wrote, is it me or are mosquito bites getting even more itchy every year? Mate, I don't think it's just you. Keith Donovan said, I could listen to the British pronunciation of mosquitoes all day. Wait, how do you guys say it? Mosquito. Mosquito? Mosquito. Mosquito. I really don't think it's that different. Red Mist said, mosquitoes go extinct. Godzilla wakes up to keep the balance by killing half of our civilization. Damn it, Godzilla. So guys, that is the end of the video. Thank you once again for making this far. Please do leave me a comment or a thumbs up to show me that you like this video. And also, stick around for the future. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate. I'll catch you in the next video. But until then, please do stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning.